Hello, this is Bullet, aka the Passive Aggressive Sherpa. In today's video, I want to talk about Bungie's latest development update. Last night, I pretty much just read their blog post back to you. I wanted to comment on it more, but there was just so much to get through, and I felt like these needed time. It's easy to read through and like the changes, or maybe not like the changes, at first glance. So I wanted to kind of let it sink in for the night and before I really got into commenting on the things that I read. I don't know if it's all sank in yet or not, but there's some things that stand out that I feel are worth talking about. These include their list of content categories, Eververse, and the things they've got going on for the next three big updates. So let's dive in. I know that many people were offended that some content wasn't available to those who didn't get the Curse of Osiris expansion pack. Though I understand their point of view, I kind of have to side with Bungie more on this. If you plan on keeping Destiny or playing it and you don't get the expansion packs, that's obviously you're not going to be able to have access to some of that content. And when they come out with something like a heroic strike list, and there's going to be new strikes on that list, and I can understand why they didn't make that available at first to those who didn't get the expansion pack. That being said, I didn't like that they had taken events like faction rallies and the Iron Banner and removed access to those things, because people already had access to that prior to it. And then to say, oh, expansion pack, now you can't do it, that's wrong. Heroic strikes hadn't been in the game until the expansion pack. They were part of that. You know, I don't care what they did in Destiny 1. This isn't Destiny 1. They're doing something new, and I appreciate that. So, you know, buy the expansion pack or shut up. That's my opinion. But if it was something that we already had access to then take it away because of an expansion pack, that is wrong. Eververse. Such a hot topic, and this one I have wanted to rant about for a while. I've started many videos on this topic that were never finished because I was so upset with Bungie, and if I'm being honest, a lot of the community for their suggestions like killing Tess pissed me off too. First off, Tess is a character. I like Tess. I like her voice. I like the concept behind her. I like having a store. I don't want her to be dead. But I don't like that Bungie hid all these amazing things behind her. And that pretty much the only way to get them was to buy silver. That is offensive. That to me borders on criminal, especially in the lottery-esque type of way that they put it together. That I found repulsive. I play this game 8 to 10 hours most days. I earn a lot of bright engrams. And I almost never get anything exotic from these engrams. It seems like once Curse of Osiris was released, everything stopped. My exotic engram rate, it didn't just drop, it went missing. I have discovered that if I use 3 of coins and just grind public events, I can usually get an exotic to drop once in about 4 hours. But XP issues and earning those bright engrams, I hadn't gotten an exotic ghost ship, sparrow, or emote since Halloween. One finally dropped a few days ago. It was the selfie emote. And when you consider I average at least 3 bright engrams a day, one would think that I'd have every exotic from Eververse that's available. And that's just not the case. There are tons of them I don't have. The system, as far as I'm concerned right now, is a flat-out fraud. I'm thrilled they'll be putting a path to earn these things in the game. But keep in mind, it doesn't appear these changes are going to be here until at least mid-February when they bring back Crimson Days, their Valentine's Day themed event. And of course, the XP system is still broke. Not much to cover here. They still have no idea how to fix it, and their rambling on about it only frustrates me. I spent money buying things to boost my XP gains at Eververse and at the store. I bought things that I could redeem for codes, you know, out in the outside world to get things to boost my XP. And to realize that I was popping those things and there were whole sections of time where my XP was being throttled, that is criminal. That is absolutely fraud, and it pisses me off. The fact that they can't figure something out that's this simple to fix, it just frustrates me. What they're doing is sitting there trying to find the best math to screw us the least, and that I don't like. Also, coming with Crimson Days in February will be some content changes to Nightfall and Raids 2. This sounds great. The idea of getting exotic sparrows, emotes, and so on to drop from completing these events is awesome. If that is the case, I plan to grind whatever Nightfall is out. I'm all over it. Another thing they're going to do during the event is award us Crimson Engrams and Bright Engrams each time we rank up. Double Engrams sounds great to me. Very much looking forward to that. And each of these Crimson Engrams have a higher chance of dropping new items until you've obtained everything that's available. And that is awesome. Now we need to talk about what to expect over the next three updates. The next significant update will be January 30th, and a lot's on the way. The standouts being Masterworks for Armor. It's about time. The main perk appears to be that it will boost armor while your super is active. Like the sound of that. Then they plan to rework the reward system for the raids. None of this means anything to me because I think raids are stupid. But for those of you that love them, they're looking to add rewards that are raid specific. They did this in Destiny 1. They should have had it already in Destiny 2. But as I always say, if they ever did anything right the first time, they wouldn't be Bungie. Oh, and a new ghost will be added as with raid theme perks. So I suppose if you do raids, that'd be great. I'd like to see something like that for Nightfall. But Nightfall, no love. The February update interests me more. They're going to be adding scoring to strikes. This will also apply to Nightfall. This will be replacing the time limit mechanic. Not sure if this is a good thing or not. I like the time limit. I just think it needs to be extended. I think they're making this more difficult than it needs to be. They can do the score things like they did in the first Destiny. All they need to do is just make it 30 minutes for normal mode, 15 minutes for prestige. It's simple. But again, not Bungie's way. They can never do anything simple. They have to sit there and change everything and shit we didn't even want changed. But maybe this new change will be better. I'm cautiously optimistic. Also in this update, what they're calling Mods 2.0, they plan to fully rework armor and weapon mods and make them greatly increase your impact on power. Sounds cool. I think that's needed. This update is also when they plan to introduce the duplicate protection on exotics. It won't cancel it, but their plan is to keep you from getting the same exotic twice in a row. This is kind of pointless to me. I don't care if I get the same exotic twice in a row. What I do care about is not getting any exotic that I already have twice in a row. So this seems to be a completely futile endeavor. We had hoped for a true duplicate protection, and this really isn't it, but at least it's something. Now, one of the updates in February that I'm really looking forward to will be able to find our fire teams on the maps. As it is now, if they fast track to a different area of the map, we can't see them. We have to sit there and ask them where they're at. After the February update, we'll now be able to find them. This is a small change, but a much needed change. Lastly, the spring update. They promise a lot here. Things that stand out to me are new content for the Crucible and competitive play. They're also adding a progression ranking. These are Valor and Glory. It'll be interesting to see how these rankings play out. Also, they'll be bringing back private games. I think it's a good idea. Not something I'd ever use unless I was searching for a dead ghost or was with a fire team and wanted to test out new armor for a video, but still very useful. Mayhem will also be making its return as a limited time thing, and I think that's a good idea. The most important update is making a change to make quitting less common. Personally, I hate quitters. There should be a three strikes and you're out mentality. I understand spawning into a match and then backing out because you couldn't get out of the playlist in time. Oh, also there's a couple of other changes worth mentioning. If you grind heroic strikes or crucible matches like I do, you know how frustrating it is when you get the same map multiple times in a row. I will admit I once backed out of a strike right after spawning into it because it was the third time in a row it had put me in the strike. I just couldn't take it anymore. For my sanity, I was out. Then they plan to add another 50 slots to our vault, with more changes to come. But that should ease things up for a bit until they can implement a complete solution. And finally, something they've been teasing for a while that I'm really excited about, the multi-emote option. I really look forward to that because sometimes I need to flip out and sometimes I need to take a selfie. It'll be nice to just be able to do it without having to swap out emotes. Should be a really fun feature. And that's it for this video. If you like this video, please give it the thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel for more moderately informative and entertaining stuff. Once again, this is Bullet, aka the Angry Sherpa, aka the Passive Aggressive Sherpa. And if we could get 2,787 likes in this video, that'd be great. Thanks for watching.